You are so, in all the films you are playing, it's, every film is so different. And it's really amazing and to see her and, you know, we showed the 100 yen love and now the 0.5 millimeters and it's really amazing to see you here. And how was it to work with your sister?
まあ、最後まで暑い中ありがとうございます。最初に質問させてもらいます。本当に一つ一つ違う作品で一つ一つの作品で違う演技をしてらっしゃって素晴らしいと思います。今回の映画祭では100円の恋も上映させていただきました。まあ、質問ですが、お姉さんと今回映画を撮りましたが、その経験はいかがでしたか？
はい、まず質問の答えの前に、こんなすごくやっぱり暑い中ずっと今入ってきたら、まだ上映中は皆さん本当に始まった時のまま皆さん私ずっと暑くてみんな出ちゃうんじゃないかなって思ってたんですけど、ずっと本当満席のままですごく嬉しくて本当に暑い中ありがとうございます。
Thanks so much for staying until the end in this heat. When I was here in the beginning, I thought people would start leaving because it's so hot during the film. But when I came in at the end of the film, I saw there was a full house. So I'm very pleased. Thank you very much.
Thank you. プレンダー。姉と一緒に作品を作るのは、これは本当に何か父も監督であったりするんですけど、でも特別にやはり姉と作品を作るっていうのは違くて、まあ、そうですね、普通に仕事の現場ではもう全くのスタッフの一員とキャストの一員として他の映画と変わらないんですけど、こう作っていくという過程ではやはり姉と私は同じ両親から生まれて、同じ時代に生まれて、同じものをずっと感じながら二人の姉妹でこう育ってきたので、すごく生物として一番近い生物で、だから何かこう表現をしたりこう作っていく相手としてはやはりすごく特別な存在だなというふうに今回映画を作って感じました。
I was the first time working with my elder sister. My father is actually also a director as well. But still, it was a unique experience working with my own sister. On the set, it was always that we were just one member of the crew, one member of the cast. So there was no difference to working with other film sets. But actually, through working with my sister, of course, we were from the same generation. We grew up in the same place. We saw the same things, so we grew up together, and in that sense, we're as living beings, we're the closest to one another, more so than any other living being in the world. So in that sense, this sort of flowed into the expression, and it was an interesting experience in that sense.
There are some questions from the audience.
The question was about the first scene, and it's about, sorry, I have to go back. So it's about the first scene where the main character says that she agrees to sleep in the same bed as the old man. And the question is, because the comment was that would be inconceivable in Europe, the question is whether that's something connected to Japanese culture in the sense that it's more difficult to say no, particularly in working situations. 仕事場で。
全くそういう文化はありません。
There's no such culture in Japan. The comment was that the music choices were fantastic, and the question is why was this shot in Kochi city? Yeah.
これはまあ私が監督に聞いた話なんですけども、そうですね、高知にうちの父がエグゼクティブプロデューサーで入っているんですけど、高知に行った時にもともとその監督は小説からこの作品を書いていて、でもこういうことが可能、こういうストーリーが本当に具体的に あのリアリティを持って可能になる場所っていうのが監督の中でこうどこがいいんだろうっていうのはずっと考えていたんですね。である日うちの父が高知に行って、そしたらもうあここでここだってうちの父が思ったみたいなんです。それで何のか相談も監督にないままあの記者の前で次はここで映画を撮るって言ってしまったんです先に。それでうちの姉は何それ、そんな行ったこともないし知らないよって言って急いで見に行ったら、あここだってもう本当にその素晴らしい景色とか、そのすごく高知っていう場所はとてもファンタジックななんか景色だったり人柄だったりがなんかちょっとファンタジーな感じの場所なんですね。すごくこう見ていただいたように綺麗ですし景色も、それでもちろんとても高齢者の多い町で、それで監督ももうここで撮ろうっていうふうに決めたそうです。
This film is originally adapted from a novel, but when the story was going to be made into a reality in the film, the director was really thinking hard about where this could take place, this film could take place. And our father is actually one of the producers of the film, and he visited Kochi and sort of came to a realization that this is the place that has to be shot. And without even discussing it with my sister, the director, revealed to the press that they had decided that they're going to shoot there. And so my sister was like, what? Why? I mean, I've never even been to Kochi. But so she made a quick visit and realized, actually, this is the place. This is where it could be shot. As you saw in the film, there's a great view. It's quite, in a sense, the people and the view is, it creates a sort of fantasy atmosphere as well. And as well as being beautiful, there's a high percentage of the population are old people in the space. So it was also appropriate in that sense.
かなり、彼女がもともと住んでた東京からは遠い場所なんですけど、高知っていうのはそこに移住してこの撮影の後に結婚して今子供を2ヶ月前に産んで高知に住んでます。
So the director after shooting the film decided that she would like to live here in Kochi, and it's quite far from where she used to live, which is Tokyo, but she moved there after the shoot, and she's since been married and also gave birth to a child.
まず最初起こったのはすごく最悪な出来事が起こったなというふうには思いますけど、でも彼女のその後のこう暮らし方を見るとやはりなんかこう彼女はそれからその今この現代にすごく必要ななんかまあすごくいいとってもいいヒーローではないけどある意味では現代に必要なヒーローになったんじゃないかなと思っていますし、彼女はこうやはり人間が持っているどうこう人とコミュニケーションを取るかっていう部分にすごく長けている人間だと思うんで、それをもうフルに活用できている彼女のこう生き様っていうのはすごく素敵だなっていうふうには思います。で、彼女がこれからどういうふうに生きていくかっていうのは私はこの映画の後にあんまり考えたくなくてあんまり考えませんでしたけど、でもこうストーリーの中でじゃなくてまた彼女が違う場所に行っていろいろな人をとこうお相手になんかまたおじいちゃんをなんだろう おじいちゃん最後の残り少ない時間のおじいちゃんにいい生き方をさせられるなんかこう魔法をいろんなところでかけていってあげたいなああかけていってくれたらいいなっていうふうに思います。
The first incident that happens to her is truly tragic, but it causes a change in lifestyle, which I feel it puts her sort of skills in sort of human communication into full use. She's able to put her sort of skills in that department in full use, and she's not a great hero by any means, but she's sort of a hero that we need now. That's what I feel about her. And I think how she puts her skills with human communication into use is really captivating and beautiful. As for her future, I don't really want to think about it, and I've not really given much thought about her future beyond the story that you just saw. But I guess what I could predict is that she would continue onwards in her journey and meet other people, probably older people, and would make these older people enjoy their last moments in their life, cast a bit of magic into their lives before in their last moments.